Welcome to Learning Life.
In this video, we'll share with you how our solar system works and some really cool things that will happen in it. Like, did you know that Jupiter has a never-ending storm that doesn't even move?
Come and join us on our journey through space!
We'll start this journey with the Sun and then jump out to the last planet in our solar system before we come back in towards the Sun again.
Every planet circles the Sun because of the Sun's powerful gravitational pull. This force pulls the planets in orbit around the Sun. Otherwise, they might fly off into space.
Ah!
Oh no, that would be crazy!
If there was no Sun, not only would Earth fly off crazily, but there would be no life on Earth at all. It would be super freezing. No plant life could grow. No life could exist here on Earth at all. There would be no light, no heat, no anything.
Oh no, I'm dying!
Interesting fact about the Sun. Did you know that that one solar flare from the Sun can be bigger than Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system? Interesting fact number two. Did you know that you could fit about 1 million Earths into the Sun? That is one big star, even though it's only a medium-sized star when compared to others further out in the universe.
Now let's look at the planets in our solar system. First, let's start with the one furthest away from the Sun, Neptune.
Interesting fact. Did you know that Pluto was considered the furthest planet from the Sun for about 70 years? But in 2006, it was recategorized and is now known as one of 5 officially recognized dwarf planets in our solar system. The others are called Ceres, Haumea, Makemake, and Eris. Interestingly, there may actually be as many as 10,000 dwarf planets in our solar system.
Oh my goodness, that is amazing!
This is Neptune, the 8th planet from the Sun. The color of Neptune is dark blue because of the atmosphere of Neptune. It's made up of methane gas. Neptune has small, thin rings around it, and it has at least 14 moons.
Interesting fact about Neptune. Did you know that it takes Neptune 165 Earth years to orbit the Sun? That means 1 year on Neptune is equal to 165 years on Earth.
Wow, everyone on Earth is less than one on Neptune.
Now, let us move on to the 7th planet from the Sun, Uranus.
Uranus is a beautiful light blue color, also because of the atmosphere is filled with methane, just like Neptune. Interestingly, scientists don't know why Uranus is a brighter color of blue than Neptune. Also, Uranus has 27 moons that we know of.
Interesting fact about Uranus. Did you know that even though Neptune is further from the Sun, the lowest temperatures of any planet in our solar system are on Uranus? While the average temperature on Neptune is colder, the coldest temperature on Uranus is colder than the coldest temperature on Neptune.
Brr, I'm so cold.
Moving on to the 6th planet from the Sun, Saturn.
Saturn is the 2nd biggest planet in our solar system and has 62 known moons and at least 150 different space objects orbiting it. Saturn is famous for its beautiful, thick, icy rings, which are much bigger than Neptune's rings.
Interesting fact about Saturn. Did you know that Saturn is the least dense planet in our solar system? Actually, it is even less dense than water, which means that if you put Saturn in an incredibly massive swimming pool, Saturn would actually float on the top of it.
What? That's amazing! Space is so cool!
Now, moving on to Jupiter, the fifth planet from the Sun.
All of the planets we have been talking about so far, including Jupiter, are considered to be gas giants. This means all of these planets we've talked about so far are big balls of gas. It also means there is no surface on any of these planets. Jupiter is the biggest planet in our solar system. In fact, all of the other planets in our solar system could fit into Jupiter. Jupiter's gravitational pull is 4 times stronger than Earth's, meaning if there was a surface to stand on, you would constantly be pancaked down on the ground. And if anything falls down from the sky of Jupiter, it falls down 4 times faster. Also, Jupiter has 67 known moons that orbit it.
Interesting fact about Jupiter. Did you know that scientists think that if there is any other place in our solar system that could support human life, Jupiter's moon Europa is one of the most likely. Other possible places include two of Saturn's moons, Titan and Enceladus, as well as Mars and Venus.
I want to live on Mars. Let's go.
Okay, let's go to Mars, the fourth planet from the Sun.
In between Mars, also known as the red planet, and Jupiter, is the asteroid belt. And the asteroid belt is like a ring of asteroids separating Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune from Mars, Earth, Venus, and Mercury. Humans are actively trying to figure out how to step foot on Mars. Maybe humans will even try to live there soon. Mars has 2 moons called Phobos and Deimos.
Interesting fact about Mars. Mars has ice, and sometimes the ice melts to water. However, while on Earth, water is made of 1 oxygen and 2 hydrogen molecules, H2O, on Mars, it's different. It's made of 2 hydrogen molecules and 1 CO2. So, it would not be drinkable.
I would not want to drink that water.
Moving on to the third rock from the Sun, the one you know best of all.
You have definitely heard of this planet, the third planet from the Sun. It's Earth. It is where you are right now, probably, unless you're watching this from the International Space Station. So we can talk less about this planet. Earth is a sister planet of Venus. This is because its mass and size is very similar, even though Earth is a small bit bigger than Venus.
Interesting fact. Do you know I live on Earth?
Let's talk about Earth's sister planet right now. Moving on to the second planet from the Sun, Venus.
Venus, like we were talking about, is the sister planet of Earth. But one thing that it's not similar at all is the temperature. Earth's average temperature is 57 degrees Fahrenheit, 14 degrees Celsius. But the average temperature on Venus is almost 900 degrees Fahrenheit, 482 degrees Celsius. That's why this is the hottest planet in our solar system. It's hot because it's both close to the Sun and because of its orange clouds that trap the heat.
It's too hot for me.
Moving on to the first planet from the Sun, Mercury.
Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system. It's even smaller than some moons. This planet Earth's temperature reaches as high as 800 degrees Fahrenheit, 427 degrees Celsius. That is burning, but still not as hot as Venus. Interestingly, the side of Mercury not facing the Sun gets as cold as minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit, minus 180 degrees Celsius.
That's too hot and cold for me.
Interesting fact about Mercury. Since it is close to the Sun, it spins around the Sun quite quickly. 1 year on Mercury lasts only 88 Earth days. However, Mercury rotates slowly around its axis, so a day on the surface of Mercury lasts 176 Earth days. If you do the math, this means that 2 years on Mercury is about equal to 1 day on Mercury.
What? That's a little too confusing for me.
This is going to be the end of our conversation.
If you like this video, please subscribe to this channel.
Bye-bye.